Well, hello, Shawn Buckley.
Hi, how are you?
I am absolutely so pleased that you have come to the courthouse in Newmarket, where we are gathered today with Michael Schmidt and the sentencing of what we've had to deal with the milk, the raw milk issue.
Yeah, I'm actually really pleased to be here. You know what? It's very rare that you find somebody like Michael that is so willing to live his ethics.
Yeah.
That it's important for people to come and support him.
Yeah.
So, and what he's doing is tied into, I mean, raw milk is a very important issue because it shows, you know, very clearly how much control the state is taking over what we can eat and what we can drink.
Right.
And I think it was Thomas Jefferson that said, if we allow the government to control what we eat, what we drink, that we're subjecting ourselves to the worst form of tyranny.
Yes.
And I think that's what's happening. Isn't it fantastic that educated adults cannot choose to actually drink raw milk in Canada, that they have to hide it from the government? And to me, that's just absurd. And I have enormous respect for what Michael's doing, and I think it's important for people to get involved.
Yeah.
Because the only reason we're losing our freedoms is because there aren't enough people saying, no, we actually have control over our own bodies, and we will not allow the government or the police or anyone to take control over it.
Exactly, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what about the sentence itself? I mean, what do you
Well, actually, I mean, why don't we talk about the decision itself first?
Decision, yeah, okay.
Because one of the things that really struck me about the decision, actually, there's three things.
Okay.
So first of all, if anyone wants to go and look at the original trial decision, it was wonderful. The JP who had acquitted Michael really said that we have the right to decide what to do with our own bodies.
Exactly.
It was a beautiful decision. And his interpretation of the Ontario law was a reasonable interpretation. And why did the Ontario government feel it was necessary to appeal that? Because that in itself says something.
Yeah.
Really, I mean, we were talking about 150 families.
Yes.
Who were educated, they were motivated, they wanted to get together and access this raw milk. Why was it important to the government to say to these 150 families, a very small number in Ontario, that no, we are actually with force going to use the court system and the police to say you cannot access raw milk for yourself and your family?
Exactly. Like,
so just philosophically, when you take a step back and say, well, why did they want to do this? So they appeal in the first place, which sends a very strong message about how the government feels about our right to choose what to eat. The second thing I found interesting about this appeal decision, well, first of all, it's actually, I think it was paragraph 96 of the decision where the judge says we do not have a constitutional right to drink raw milk. So that's what the government wanted.
Which is what we certainly don't agree with.
No, but to get there, to get at that decision, the court had to say, because Michael had led evidence from some of the people who rely on raw milk, both on religious grounds and health grounds, that they need access. And the court said, I'm not going to look at that evidence. You don't have the right, the legal term is you don't have standing, to actually lead that evidence. Yeah. I've done a lot of legal research on standing because we've argued it.
Yeah.
And I can tell you that I'm not aware of another decision where somebody is charged with an offense where they don't have legal standing. I've never seen that before. I think this decision's actually wrong at law on that point.
I see.
So, you know, it's interesting, as I say, on the three grounds. First of all, why did the government feel the need to take away raw milk from these 150 families?
Yeah.
And, you know, step away from a decision that said we actually have the right to choose what to eat.
Yeah.
Like, what was offensive about that?
Yeah.
And then secondly, you know, the fact this new decision says we don't have the right to drink raw milk, and we won't even consider evidence from, you know, people that rely on it. It's quite scary, actually.
And the insistence that you know, that what Michael does falls under the Milk Act. I mean,
yeah, I mean, the whole thing I find offensive, but I find it offensive on freedom grounds.
Yeah.
As I say, when the government is saying that we can't choose how to nourish ourselves.
Exactly.
Like, I can't drink store-bought milk, personally.
Yeah.
I think it's the homogenization.
Well, you see, when you think of that, a normal cow that is on, like the kind of cow that is on Michael's farm, gives 3,500 liters of milk a year. They have the factory cows, the factory raised cows, up to 30,000 liters of milk. That means almost 10 times the amount of milk from one cow. Would you want to drink that?
Well, I mean,
you I think most people get sick because they're allergic to milk. They can't drink it. You know, the babies were all allergic already 40, 50 years ago.
Right.
You know, so that kind of proves it, I mean. But anyhow, go a little bit more now into, you're going to be at the health show down in
right,
Toronto.
Right, yeah. No, I'm speaking on Sunday at the Whole Life Expo.
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually going to include the raw milk issue in my lecture because the whole purpose of the lecture is to kind of wake people up to the fact that we think we're free, but we're not.
Yeah,
and the government is in so many ways taking control over our bodies right now that we're moving into a very uncomfortable situation where the government's actually becoming adversarial towards us you know, basic human rights issues.
And there's also the Total Health Show coming up. Filming this, it is November the 25th, right? So we're coming up there.
I expect I will be there, yes.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm pretty sure I will.
Yeah.
So I've been there for the past several years.
There we go. Now tell me a little bit about what's happening with the NHPPA.
Well, we've actually been working on doing a lot of legal research because we think that we need to bring a constitutional challenge.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, we're almost done that.
As far as I remember, you have to have the actual papers. It's not
poll. What's slowing us down right now is we need primarily companies that are willing to step up to the plate and say, I'm willing to be a party.
Uh-huh.
But a lot of them tell us they don't want to be a party because they feel then they'll be a target and that Health Canada will go after them.
Well, this is the problem. So in other words, our own government is fear-mongering, really.
Well, but, I mean, it's legitimate. I mean, look at what's happening to Michael here with almost $10,000 in fines when he's just testified he doesn't have any income and any assets.
Exactly, yeah.
So, the state has a very heavy hand, and the state is very serious about enforcing its laws.
Mm-hmm.
And companies, I mean, I
And they're very
I don't think
serious
they're...
about not changing the laws, too. I mean,
oh,
the
very
laws
serious.
The way that we want... I mean, but, as you can tell with your own...
But the problem is until people decide that they're willing to stand up for what they believe in,
mm-hmm.
the system won't change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there have
and
to
that's
be more
not,
people.
That applies to individuals, it applies to companies.
Yeah.
We all need to just make a decision that what's going on here is ethically wrong.
We're
going to stand for our principles, and if that means that we're going to get hurt, then we have to be willing to be hurt.
Like Michael is, with his hunger strike for what... I think it was 34 days or something.
Yeah, it's
like
amazing,
that.
Isn't it?
37 days, actually. I mean, for somebody not to eat anything for 37 days, that's quite something.
Yes.
So, you know, I don't know. Not too many people could do that. I think they're dead before that.
Right.
But anyway, so you're off to the... So tell me, where is the show in Toronto now?
Oh, I think it's at the convention center.
The convention center.
I'm pretty sure it is.
There we go. Okay.
Isn't that terrible?
And when are you going to speak?
I think I'm speaking at 3:00 on Sunday.
Okay.
In fact, I'm pretty sure I am.
Okay, good.
So,
we'll have to look at the schedule.
Right.
Well, I mean, it's quite amazing, actually, that they have two health shows following one another.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so you
isn't
can tell.
Total Health usually was in the spring, wasn't it?
No, in January.
Oh, it's always in January.
They've already asked me to volunteer to introduce the speakers again. So I think the 26th or something like that, the end of January. So,
yeah.
And of course, we also have the conference in Guelph where, the agriculture, what's it called? Not the biodynamic, but organic, the organic conference.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's also in January. So lots of people are into this.
Yes.
So anyways, I would like to thank you, Shawn, and good luck. And if I can make it, I'll be there on Sunday to film you what you're going to say.
Appreciate
all right?
that, and thanks
all
for
right.
the opportunity to speak with you.
Yeah. All right then,
okay.
Shawn. Thanks.
I got a cute one.
Did you get it?
Yeah, it's cute. Hold the camera still when you take it.
Get him.
Just bend the screen. There we go. snacks over here, Michael.
Oh, look at him. There we go.
Very sweet.
Hello, Bernadette.
The other thing is that I want to say that actually unintentionally, the raw milk glass has become the symbol of the food rights movement.
Yeah.
Because it is not, and I think the judge understood, it's really not about milk. It is about your rights to make a proper decision in regards to what you put in your body. And that regulatory rules do not consider your individual. I mean, the judge said it was anecdotal that you have health benefits of it. And I think that is what we can easily prove, that these things are not anecdotal, that freedom cannot be anecdotal. Freedom is right. I want to toast with Alice Jongerton. She is on the other side of the country, pursued by health officials as the cow share operator, charged and convicted. And we kind of toasting with the purity of the milk for a better future. Thank you all for coming. Cheers to the queen.
Cheers.
Cheers
to the queen.
Who drinks raw milk?
The queen. And this is definitely not the end of this battle.
Yep.
As the judge said, he said, I'm sure you will continue, and that is really important. So I want to thank also everyone involved, the judge, the prosecutors. They were kind of baffled about what happened today. And they said it will be a long journey themselves. And that's great. They have a steep learning curve to understand what this is all about. Cheers. And the sun is shining on our head.
Yeah.